अस्सलामु अलैकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहू। माय नेम इज़ अफशा बानो, रोल नंबर BP1650014, एंड टुडे द टॉपिक आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट इज़ फिनेटोइन सोडियम। सो फर्स्टली वी विल स्टार्ट विद द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ फिनेटोइन सोडियम। फिनेटोइन इज़ बेसिकली अ हाइडेंटोइन कंपाउंड दैट इज़ रिलेटेड टू बारबिट्यूरेट्स and is basically an effective anticonvulsant used for the treatment of tonic-clonic or partial seizures and for the acute treatment of generalized status epilepticus. So anticonvulsants are basically group of drugs which are used in the treatment of epileptic seizures. And what is epilepsy? So epilepsy is basically a CNS disorder in which the brain activity becomes abnormal and it causes seizures or periods of unusual behaviors, like we have sensations and sometimes loss of awareness, loss of consciousness. And what is seizure? So seizure is basically a sudden uncontrolled electrical disturbance in the brain. Now what's the mechanism of action by which phenytoin act as anticonvulsant? So phenytoin is basically a sodium channel blocker, and by blocking the sodium channel it act as anticonvulsant. It blocks the voltage gated sodium channels in the neuronal membrane and it results in the prolongation of the inactivated state of the sodium channel and the refractory period of the neuron. Now the main indications in which we use phenytoin is the drug of choice for generalized tonic clonic seizures, and sometimes it also used in migraine condition. Now the side effects that are associated with the use of phenytoin is nystagmus. Nystagmus is basically a vision condition in which the eyes just make a repetitive uncontrolled movement. We have diplopia. Diplopia is also a vision problem in which you see two images of the same thing, or it is also known as double vision. It may occur in one eye or in both eye, but double vision in both eye is more serious than in one eye. And the other side effects, we have sedation, gingival hyperplasia, hirsutism, anemia, peripheral neuropathy, osteoporosis, induction of hepatic drug metabolism. Now the drug toxicity that are associated with phenytoin may cause cardiotoxicity, and it is also teratogenic, and it should be avoided in pregnant women because it is also teratogenic and a human transplacental carcinogen. So several tumors may be observed in the newborn baby if the mother is exposed to this drug phenytoin during gestation period. And it also decreases insulin secretion in type 2 diabetes, so it should be prohibited in pregnancy and type 2 diabetes patient. Now, as we know, phenytoin is no longer considered as a first-line treatment due to number of side effects or the adverse effects that are associated with the use of phenytoin. So we have 6 other alternative drugs which we can use instead of using phenytoin. These all are belongs to anticonvulsants, and the drugs are lamotrigine, oxcarbazepine, carbamazepine, topiramate, divalproex, levetiracetam. Doses of phenytoin for adult is 150 to 300 mg OD per oral, for neonatal 4 to 5 mg per kg BDIV, and for pediatric 3.75 to 4.5 mg BD oral. Dosage adjustment should be done if the patient is having renal failure, or if the patient is pediatric, or the patient is pregnant woman. In pregnant women, the dose should be reduced to 50%. वैसे हमें अवॉइड करना चाहिए फिनेटोइन सोडियम को इन प्रेगनेंट वुमेन, क्योंकि ये फीटल कार्सिनोजेनिक भी है, टेराटोजेनिक भी है। लेकिन अगर आपको नेसेसरी हो प्रेगनेंसी के अंदर भी फिनेटोइन देना, तो आपको 50% रिडक्शन इन द डोज करनी है। और चूंकि जो डोजेज प्रिपेयर की जाती है वो अडल्ट के लिहाज से की जाती है, तो वो पेडियाट्रिक आपने डोज को इस तरीके से एडजस्ट करना है कि 5 मिलीग्राम पर केजी पर डे ओरली इन 2 or 3 इक्वली डिवाइडेड डोसेस। नाउ drug interactions that are associated with phenytoin basically cause induction of cytochrome P450. So metabolism of the drug that are substrate for these cytochrome P450 isoenzymes can be enhanced by the use of phenytoin sodium. And phenytoin may directly interact with many drugs like orlistate, vitamin B6, sucralfate, and many others. Now available dosage form of phenytoin is capsule immediate release, extended release capsules, chewable tablets, oral suspensions, injectable solutions. Phenytoin capsules are basically indicated for the control of generalized tonic-clonic seizures and psychomotor seizures and prevention and treatment of seizures occurring during or following a neurosurgery. Tonic-clonic seizure basically involve both the things like tonic and clonic. Tonic means stiffening and clonic means twitching or jerking phases of muscle activity, means it affects more than one part or two part of the brain. Phenytoin injection is used to treat primary generalized tonic-clonic seizure, which was formerly known as grand mal seizure, and seizure that involves the entire body, and to treat and prevent seizures that may begin during or after surgery to the brain or the nervous system. एक और कैटेगरी हमारे पास बेसिकली होती है सीज़र की, विच इज़ नोन एज अ पार्शियल सीज़र. सो पार्शियल सीज़र इज़ बेसिकली अ सीज़र डेट अफेक्ट्स ओनली वन पार्ट ऑफ द ब्रेन, और वहाँ पे ओनली ट्विचिंग होती है, जो स्टिफनिंग है वो नहीं होती पार्शियल सीज़र के अंदर. नाउ अवेलेबल ब्रांड्स ऑफ फिनिटोइन इज डिलेंटिन, एपिटोइन, एपिनेट, फिनाइटेक. अमंग ऑल अगर हम देखें तो मोस्ट फार्माको इकोनॉमिक वी हैव एपिनेट, बट डिलेंटिन मोस्टली यूज़ की जाती है. Now, rationale use of phenytoin, that is a use for which phenytoin is indicated, and it is basically used to control certain type of seizure but not for all type of seizure. It is used to treat and prevent seizures that may begin during or after surgery to the brain or nervous system. Irrational use of phenytoin occur when we give the same dose to the renal compromised patient or to the pregnant woman or to the pediatric patient, because to all these dosage adjustment should be done. Irrational use may occur if you overprescribe the medication, and the overdose or the overprescribing may lead to many different side effects or the adverse effects like uncontrollable eye movements, loss of consciousness, vomiting, it may cause nausea, irregular heartbeat, chest pain, shortness of breath. Or with if without using OD, the patient uses phenytoin BD or TID, so it may also lead to irrational use of phenytoin. Now, case study associated with phenytoin. JN, an 18-year-old, 88 kg male student, was diagnosed with epilepsy. He experiences generalized tonic-clonic seizure that lasts 2 minutes approximately 3 times monthly. JN describes a churning feeling in his abdomen before his seizure. This is followed by involuntary right-sided jerking of upper extremities, during which JN is awake and aware of his surroundings. His seizure has been observed and described well both by his family and by nursing staff who cared for him during a brief hospitalization following his first seizure. An EEG showed diffuse slowing with focal epileptiform discharges in the left temporal area. It was interpreted as abnormal. No correctable cause for his seizure disorder was identified despite a thorough workup. He has no other medical condition and takes no routine medication. He was treated initially with carbamazepine up to 600 mg per day. He could not tolerate the medication because of nausea and diplopia despite relatively low doses. His physician has elected to implement a therapeutic trial of phenytoin for JN, recommend an initial dosage, and what information should be provided to JN about his new medication. So, firstly, we have subjective. Gender male, age 18 year, weight 88 kg. Onset is churning feeling in abdomen before his seizure. Stomach churning or churning feeling in abdomen is basically an uncontrollable agitated sensation that is caused by a variety of stomach and intestinal issue, and also caused due to seizure. Location is upper extremities. Duration is seizure lasts 2 minutes approximately 3 times monthly. Characterization is EEG showed diffuse slowing with focal epileptiform discharges in the left temporal area. What is EEG? EEG is basically an electroencephalogram, that is basically a test that detects electrical activity in your brain using a metal disc or the electrodes attaching to your scalp. Current problem is generalized tonic-clonic seizure, and previous medication that the patient was taking is carbamazepine up to 600 mg per day. Objective, EEG is abnormal. assessment as he was treated initially with carbamazepine up to 600 milligram per day, but he could not tolerate the medication even with the low doses, and he also experienced different side effects or the adverse effect of the medication. So we can switch the patient to any other anti-epileptic drugs, such as phenytoin or any other, and then we can check the response of the patient, that if the patient is tolerating that medication or not. Plan. An initial phenytoin dosage of 400 milligram per day would be appropriate for him. That is a dosage of approximately 4.5 milligram per kg per day. Now, to avoid the patient non-adherence because of phenytoin or because of the transient side effect associated with phenytoin, he could be instructed to take 100 milligram in the morning and 100 milligram 12 hours later for 1 week. हम डोज को डिवाइड कर देंगे ताकि जो साइड इफेक्ट एसोसिएटेड है विद फेनोटोइन उसको हम अवॉइड कर सके पेशेंट के अंदर. द फॉलोइंग वीक ही कुड टेक 100 मिलीग्राम इन द मॉर्निंग एंड 200 मिलीग्राम 12 आवर लेटर. जैसे जैसे वो डोज उसके अंदर एडजस्ट होने लगेगी हम डोज को इंक्रीज कर सकते हैं. इफ ही कैन टॉलरेट दिस रेजिमन ही कुड देन टेक 200 मिलीग्राम एवरी 12 आवर्स. फर्स्टली हम 100-100 से स्टार्ट करेंगे, फिर हम 100-200 तक जाएंगे, और अगर उसको पेशेंट टॉलरेट कर सकता हो तो हम 200-200 every 12 hour phenytoin ki dosage ko use karenge us patient ke andar. Now the information that should be provided to the patient before prescribing phenytoin. He should be informed that he may experience initial mild sedation from phenytoin. He should be cautioned that symptoms such as dysarthria. Dysarthria is basically a motor speech disorder in which the muscles that are used to produce speech are damaged, paralyzed or weakened, and the person with dysarthria cannot control their tongue or voice box and may slur words. So he should be instructed to notify his physician, pharmacist or other healthcare professional about these symptoms. And it's also a good idea to inform patient at the beginning of the therapy that adjustment of medication dosage and possibly medication changes may be necessary before the medication regimen is stabilized. Thank you.